guys, it's Gretchen, and welcome back to my channel. It is that time of the month again where I answer your body mod questions. I have no idea what this was. It is time for the first body mods Q&A of 2021. I'm super excited. I absolutely love doing this like series on my channel where I answer your body mod questions that you have sent my way. So if you have a question that you would like to ask for February's body mod Q&A, leave them in the comments below or go follow me on Instagram. And when I pop up the little question box, which I usually do a few days before I film the video, you can ask me questions there. But before I get started with today's video, I do want to give a special thank you to our sponsor for today's video, and that is Ana Luisa. I have worked with Ana Luisa before. I absolutely love their stuff. Oh my god, like I constantly wear their jewelry now. It's my absolute favorite. But let me give you a little bit more information about them. Ana Luisa is a sustainable jewelry company that uses only the best noble metals for their jewelry. They are a carbon neutral company, which means that they offset their carbon emissions. For all the CO2 they produce in all aspects of their company, they are able to counterbalance it with oxygen. They are a luxury jewelry brand, but there are no luxury brand markups on prices. There's seriously something for everybody from Ana Luisa. When they reached out to me, like, and I started perusing their website, I was like, I am in love with everything. Everyday wear, going to work, doing videos. I love the simplistic daintiness of their jewelry. So let me just show you real fast the pieces that Ana Luisa sent me this time. So the first one is one that I'm actually wearing right now. It is the Lev, and it is basically a puffed heart, and I love this so much. Like, just look how good that looks with my outfit right now. Again, I picked this one just because it is that smaller, dainty, simple look to it. I loved the simplicity of it, but I also like how this is a little bit more of a statement. It's that puffed heart look to it. I just really like it. And this necklace retails for $59. Also, can we just talk about how absolutely adorable the packaging is for Ana Luisa? The next necklace they sent me is also a heart necklace. How convenient that, you know, Valentine's Day is coming up. We'll get to that in a minute. But it is this tiny heart moonstone. So I love moonstones. If y'all know me, I love my moonstones. My nostril piercings, like the jewelry, are moonstones. My Medusa / philtrum is a moonstone. So when I saw this one on the website, I was like, I have to have it. It's a moonstone. So I was very thrilled that they sent me this one. It's tinier compared to the puffed heart, so it adds that little bit more daintiness to it. I can't get over how utterly precious this piece is. Again, I've got two heart necklaces, you know, Valentine's Day coming up. And this retails for $75. And this last piece that they sent me, also a necklace, and to be honest, I've been wearing this quite a bit already, but it's this toggle necklace called the Amelia. I just thought it was incredibly unique compared to other jewelry that I have, so I was just like, I really kind of want that. I was very happy when I saw that this one was being sent to me. And this one retails for $59, so it's also the same price as the puffed heart. So thank you again to Ana Luisa for sponsoring this video. There will be a link in the description to their website. And like I mentioned, the heart jewelry, you know, Valentine's Day is coming up. So Ana Luisa will be having a Valentine's Day sale where you can get 15% off. So definitely if you want to pick up a piece for yourself or a loved one, definitely go check out their website, especially during this sale. I absolutely love their stuff. And if you've seen videos, you know that I wear their stuff a lot now. So thank you again to Ana Luisa. All right. Let's get into some body mod questions. Natalie asks, I got my septum pierced about 2.5 weeks ago and I really want to get some more. For my ears, I was thinking of an industrial and a forward helix, but I wanted to know out of those two, which one is good to start off with since they're both cartilage piercings and I've never had any before. So I'm looking for the least painful one to heal first. So like you mentioned in your comment, I don't have an industrial, so I can't really talk personally about an industrial. However, just speaking on how an industrial is and how a forward helix is, forward helix is only one piercing. An industrial is technically two piercings. So it kind of depends on what your lifestyle is and what you are able to essentially baby at the time. So if you're able to baby two Pearsons, an industrial is not bad. But if you think that you can only care for like one at a time, definitely go for the forward helix. I personally did not think that a forward helix was terrible to get. I'm looking to get my second one done, but I know a lot of people say that the forward helix for them was really painful. It's a hard space to get into. It's a weird cartilage area. You know, coming from the perspective that I don't have an industrial, I'm automatically gonna say a forward helix. But I feel like those with industrials will probably say the opposite. Pain is gonna be there, really and truly. There's no like definite what is a best first Pearson. Go with your gut and what you are more inclined to get. Also do your research though. Chelsea asks, bumps on my Pearsons, how do I get them to go away? I tried tea tree oil diluted, of course. I tried sea salt soaks to help, please. So if you are finding that bumps are not going away, you may be aggravating it even more by doing all of this stuff. It depends on how often you're doing it. Tea tree oil diluted is definitely a last resort. It is not like the first plan of action against bumps. The salt soaks are definitely more that. Make sure that you are doing the correct amount for a sea salt soak. Like if you're creating it yourself, definitely make sure that you're doing the correct measurements, because if you're doing too much salt and not enough water, you could be irritating it to the point where the bumps are just getting worse. So make sure that you've got your measurements correct, everything like that. My only other advice when you find there is a bump that will not go away, and this is almost like a last ditch effort, but it helped me when I had a bump on my nostril piercing that would not go away. Go to a dermatologist, get it shot with, I believe it's cortisone. I'm pretty sure it was a cortisone shot that I received because it helps reduce inflammation in the body. And it also helps with, you know, when inflammation goes down, swelling goes down. That is a last ditch effort, but if you are finding that nothing is working, also make sure that you've got good quality jewelry in there. Again, the dermatologist is like last resort. This is my last resort. Seriously, last resort. So make sure that you've got good quality jewelry in there. If you do not, find better quality jewelry. But again, getting the cortisone shot helped me. But again, last resort. Obsessed K-popper asks, what are your opinions on constellation piercings? I've heard people say they're unique and fun while others say that they are too much hassle to plan. I personally love them. I wanna say your comment was like the like one last comment that I received on constellation piercings before I made the video that I did. So if you would like to learn more about constellation piercings, you can go check out my video. Thank you for asking that question, because I've received a lot of questions about constellation piercings and my thoughts. And I honestly didn't know what it was until I researched it. So go check out the video if you wanna know my thoughts. I made an entire video about it. Deaf Deirdre asks, how do I clean out a piercing hole that turned black or dark because of the jewelry I used? So that's more than likely like something that has come off of the jewelry and it's just in your piercing hole now. The best thing to do for that is to take a Q-tip, get some H2Ocean or some Neomed spray on it, kind of press against the piercing hole. Like if it's your lobes, this is a whole lot easier if it's your lobes. Press against it so that it kind of puckers out some, and just take the Q-tip and clean around it and it should come off. That more than likely is something that has come off of jewelry and it's not actually like part of your ear now. It's just caught in there. That's what I would do when I was younger, like in high school. I would do that, except for I wouldn't do it with H2Ocean because I didn't know what H2Ocean was. I would just do it with water. So I used to do that with my lobes. Cartilage might be a little bit more difficult just because cartilage doesn't bend that easily, but you should still be able to like press on it a little bit and get it to pucker some so that you can clean it. That's probably gonna be your best way. Demka Belikov asks, what is the appropriate amount of time to book a tattoo appointment consultation? So when you say appropriate amount of time to book it, do you mean like how long do you think that you're gonna need to book for a specific consult or even a tattoo? That a lot is up to your tattoo artist. Tattoo consultations usually don't take very long, like less than 30 minutes. Every one that I've had is like 15 minutes. My consults have never been very long, but for like tattoo appointments, I give the idea to the artist. They kind of come up with something in their head, not necessarily the actual drawing, but they'll come up with something in their head and be like, all right, this is like a 3-hour window. Really and truly, the tattoo appointment time is up to the artist. If you want to break it up though, you can let them know, like if you're getting a bigger piece, you're like, I just want to do line work first, let that heal and then come back for color. That's something that they can work with too. Line work usually doesn't take that long, but it really just depends on what you're getting or how long those will be. Brandy Combs asks, what size in millimeter is your Medusa piercing? I can't find jewelry that fits good. So mine is, I'm pretty sure this is a 3 millimeter. Might be a 3.5. I don't think it's any bigger than that. I'm pretty sure it's just the 3. I like the size of it. This is definitely good at its healed state. When it was healing, I did have a smaller one, but you don't want to go too small because while it's healing, it could actually suck the jewelry through, which you do not want to do. I don't know if you're also talking about the length, but that would be inches. And I'm pretty sure this is 5/16, 7 inch. Might be 1/4. Not entirely sure. Actually, I think it is 1/4. Now that I think about it, this is very close. Like, it doesn't come anywhere near my gums or my teeth. Jay Abby Frankel asks, how does it feel having 3 nose piercings? It's not itchy? I honestly can't tell that I have nose piercings. I never can tell. The only time I can actually tell is if I'm like blowing my nose or something like that and I'm trying to get gunk out of my nose and then I like hit the piercings. That's the only time that I ever truly know that they're there. So no, it's not itchy. I will say if I have a horseshoe in there though, that drives me up a wall. I hate having a horseshoe in my septum. But otherwise, like right now, can't tell that they're in there. Dupney asks, how's your flat piercing? It's doing great. Honestly, it's been one of the best to heal. It did have a little flare up after I did like my all about my flat piercing video, but otherwise perfectly fine. I might size down on the jewelry because this is a bigger piece and it's taking up a lot of space right there. So I might size down to a smaller millimeter in diameter. Haven't decided yet. Tattoos Tattoos asks, does your boyfriend ever knock, bang, catch your new piercings? I don't think he's ever caught anything now that I think about it. He's pretty careful. Like, he's just a careful person in general. He is very conscious of his surroundings. He's very conscious of others, but I'm pretty sure I can't think of a time he's ever like hit anything of mine. Now that I think about it, like bumped up against it or accidentally like got it caught on something. That's pretty much all me. I'm the one that gets it caught and banged around on things. He's such a nice person and such a conscious person. And I'm just like, just go in whole hog. Polar opposites. I am an Aries. He's a Libra. Evelyn Vandely asks, I often wear a watch and I have tattoo on my wrist. Could this have an effect on my tattoo over time? So I also wear, I have an Apple Watch and I have a tattoo on my wrist right here. It's a book. I got it done in 2014? I don't remember what year. It was either 2014 or 2015. But I personally have not ever noticed it like rub or like make it fade or anything like that. Anything on the wrist, because it's more exposed to the elements, is gonna fade faster than other areas that are tattooed. But I personally haven't noticed like it fading faster because of the watch. As long as it's healed and everything, I don't think a watch is really gonna harm it. If anything, it might protect it from the elements because it's covering it up. Nicholas Steiger Walt asks, what are your thoughts on industrial piercings? I like them, but just with how my setup is, I wouldn't be able to have one just because there's no room. I'd have to take piercings out in order to get one. But I like them well enough, as long as you care for them properly. Because I've seen some gnarly industrial piercings of people just not caring for them. So I feel like a lot of people forget it's 2 piercings in one. So I like them, I just don't have the setup for them. PandaBear6510 asks, if you want kids, would you ever do what you and your mom do with piercings? Hell yes. I would totally be down for it. Now, I will also be the mom who will not let them get tattooed until they are of age. And dependent on the piercing, I will not let them get that until they are of age. I mean, at that point, it's not up to me, it's up to them. If I had gotten some of the tattoos I wanted when I was 15 or 16 years old, I definitely would be all gung-ho for them to get whatever. But for tattoos, they definitely gotta be 18 years old of age. And for piercings, depending on what it is, if they want a nostril piercing, I'll go with them. They want some cartilage piercings, for sure. They want their belly button pierced, yeah, that one's fine too, but there are just some, like tongue, no, you're gonna wait till you're 18. Lip, I would probably say wait till you're 18. Septum, I'd let them get before 18, because they can flip that up for school and stuff. But yeah, totally down for it. If they want to stretch their lobes, go for it. I feel like my like cutoff though is like nothing extreme before they get to high school. So like in middle school, not doing anything there. You can get your lobes pierced. I'll even let you get like, you know, 3 lobe piercings. But once you get in high school, that's when we can start like considering cartilage piercings, even some nose piercings, belly button piercings, something like that. So roundabout way, yes, I totally would. BlahFF77 asks, for nostril piercings, which type of jewelry is the best for newer piercings under a year old? I'd say anything that allows for potential swelling. Because I found within the first year, my nostril piercings would still flare up every now and then. Like right now I have just simple Labrae jewelry in my nostrils. Absolutely love it. Not sure I'd recommend that for a newer nostril piercing. I definitely am more of an L-shaped person for a newer one. I personally don't like how those feel now that I've had like Labrae jewelry in there. But that being said, the L-shape allows for a little bit more movement and to allow for potential swelling. So that's my personal preference. I don't like corkscrews. I just don't like how they feel on my nose. I don't like nose bones because I'm terrified that they're just gonna just willy-nilly pop out. So L-shapes are like my usual suggestion for a newer natural piercing, and then switch to Libre because it's a whole new world, I promise. Last question is from Ellie Federio. Parts of your body you never tattoo. Honestly, I don't want to say that there are any areas that I wouldn't tattoo. There are places that I'm scared to get tattooed, but they're not areas that I would never get tattooed. Like, I'm terrified to get the back of my thigh done. Absolutely terrified to get that one done. I just feel like that's such a sensitive area. So terrified to get that done. Terrified to get my foot done. That's why it's not done yet. I would get my hand done faster than my foot. I don't know why. So I don't think there's any area that I wouldn't get done. Maybe my scalp. You have to shave your head for that. I probably would not get my head done, but I'd get my like throat, neck, all that done. I saw a throat tattoo the other day and I was like, I want that. I want that so bad. But yeah, I think maybe that's the only area. It's just like my scalp. I think that's the only thing I wouldn't get done. So those are the questions for January's Body Mods Q&A. Thank you to everyone who submitted a question. I love doing these videos. So if you'd like to ask a question for February, leave them in the comments below. Again, thank you so much to Ana Luisa for sponsoring today's video. Their link is in the description below and also in the pinned comment below. So be sure to go check out their Valentine's Day sale for 15% off your order. You'll love their stuff, I promise. Special thank you to my patrons. You can help support the channel on Patreon while having access to videos early, viewing patron-only content, and more. But that is it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a big ol' thumbs up. Go on down there and hit that subscribe button. Wherever it may be, because I don't know, even though I do. This is just my shtick now. Also hit that notification bell in case you wanna know when I upload, and in case YouTube wants to let you know when I upload, because I would really appreciate it. And until next time, bye guys.